Hello everyone and welcome back to a new episode of Resident Evil Zero. If you enjoyed the series, remember to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment down below. I went back to the training facility to pick up the green stripping agent. We put the agents together, we got a stripping agent, and we freed this little leechy boy. They don't have teeth. It's a baby. So now we can go back. And I did lose health because I fought some unkillable zombie monkeys. They are now killable, so it makes it a little bit better. And now I can get the hell out of this place. The fact you had to either find that to begin with, just by coincidence, because there's no reason to actually click on that. Like, you'd never think to do it. It would just be coincidence that you found it. And then you'd have to remember that you saw it. Because honestly, there's no reason to even click the red canister. They're not labeled like something important. There was no reason for you to think, oh, I should be clicking on this. I just happened to, and I got the red agent. Like, there's nothing about it that suggests that this is something that you should be doing. That's bad game design. Like, everything else in this game where it's something that you need to pick up, it glows. Like, it has a shiny to it. It's like, hey, this is something you need to pick up. That has nothing. It has nothing to it. It's just, it looks like background. It looks like part of the background. And the thing about this game is that they love putting stuff in the background that you can just click on to give you random stuff. There's no reason for it. Honestly, it's more of a nuisance than anything. So it just looks like part of the background. And unless you... I guess the only reason you would click on that is because you have clicked on the background and you actually enjoy reading the stuff that the background has to say. That is the only thing that I could think of. Do I still have it? No, I don't. So I used it. So the one time, so there's going to be another one that I have to pick up. Do I need another mixing agent? Why do I feel like that's going to bust open? Sure. Photo. To James, to commemorate your graduation, 1939. Skeleton. It's a book.
That guy must be Marcus's son.
No.
Or grandson.
A thingy. You see, you're telling me it could be Marcus's grandson or son, and you know, I'm not really believing you. You know what? I bet because he said that the leeches were copying him, I bet that it is the leeches have gained sentience and they are taking on his persona of a younger him. Leech? Leech! Damn. Wait, what? What did I pick up? Oh, this. Well. Who? A green. Oh, I just happened. Okay, so it was a green one. It was a blue one. I just happened to go to the right one. Why would he put one? Are they gems? Are they not actual leeches? Also, I do like that the leeches are something that are a continuing thing throughout these games. Because even in Resident Evil, which one was it? 6? 5? 5. Even in Resident Evil 5, they had leeches. They had the ones that looked more like Las Plagas. No, actually, Las Plagas is for 4. Which one is... Well, like, not Oboes, it's something, it sounds kind of like Oboes, but that's not what it is, it's something else that I can't think of the name of. But it's a similar kind of like sounding name. But that one. Which honestly looks a lot like Las Plagas. By happenstance, I think. Instead of being leeches infected with the T-virus, it is cells turning into leeches, like leech-like entities, and it's each individual cell turning into a leech, which is one, just crazy, but two, pretty cool. Mostly just because it kind of keeps following like this storyline, which it really doesn't, because it's kind of more like a convergent thing than anything. Oh, he's just growling. I got him. Wait, is there really nothing in here? What is this? Oh, it's a sterilizing agent for the poison. And a whole bunch of bullets. You know what? Sure. There were enough bullets. I like the bullets because they stack. He can't use the bullets, but I like them. I'm actually going to send the Molotovs back up. Just in case. Molotov cocktail. And just because I can, I'm going to send the bullets back down. And then she can grow. Because she has both handguns right now. I wish she could dual wield, really. It'd be cool if one of them could dual wield. So there's a dial. I feel like I need that plug for the dial. I have the sterilizing agent. which could be for the dial, and the fuse could be for something after the dial. But I get the feeling I'm going to need a sterilizing agent to get rid of the poison, and then I'm going to need something after that. Where am I headed? Where am I going? Okay, so this room over here. Wait, isn't this where I just came from? Oh, no, it was where I just came from, but it was down here. Not for long. Did I no, I don't. It's a zombie. I love that there's a cutscene for just this little space. A breeding room key. This is where we breed. Wait a minute, there is a loading screen. Why was there a loading screen? Why did there need to be a loading screen for that? That's so bizarre. Is this the breeding room? It is. I love how the breeding room has a fucking iron door on it. Ooh, and cages. Kinky. Ah! Breeding room is spooky. BOW report. Research data shown that when the progenitor virus is administered to living organisms, violent cellular changes cause a breakdown in the system. Furthermore, no satisfactory method has been found to control the organisms for use as weapons. Clearly, greater coordination at the cellular level is essential to enable further growth. I conducted a number of experiments in an effort to find the breakthrough. This is my report. Insecta. That's insects. It's actually not actually a name. Insecta. I don't think that's the line. Perhaps because these ancient animals have been genetically stable for millennia, when administered with the progenitor virus, they exhibited only explosive high energy growth and increased aggressiveness. It's extremely difficult to envision using them as BOW. I don't see how, honestly. Like, you just let them out and, you know, they wreak havoc. Amphibia. Injecting a frog with the virus resulted in an increase in leaping power and abnormal tongue growth. However, no change in mental ability was observed. Furthermore, an abnormal appetite resulted in the test subject randomly attacking all moving objects. Usefulness as BOW is limited. Four. It's a four. Yes, four. Mammalia. Progenitor virus was merged with monkeys' cellular DNA, resulting in increased fertility. Oh my. The resulting young exhibited improved aggressiveness and some increased mental capacity. As a side effect, visual power was lost. This was offset by an improvement in hearing ability. No, I feel like they aren't actually blind, because if I move slowly, they still find me. However, they were unsatisfactory as weapons. It does seem that no progress has been made without making humans the base organism. Well, these guys did pretty well. A cage. Why? I have so many questions of why, how. Like, how did it get there? Why is it there? Why? It's because it's a video game. But how? Well, it's because it's a video game. I still live by my idea that Resident Evil were never scary games. They were low-tier action games with spooky, quotations, elements to them. But mostly, they're not even... They're action games in the sense that you can fight back. Not very well, but you can. They are more so puzzle games. Like, if you like puzzles, Resident Evil is the game for you, because at least the old ones, old Resident Evil games are the game for you. Because all this is just puzzle. It's find a thing to do a thing to find a thing to do another thing to do a thing to do a thing. It's all puzzle. It's find A to get to B to get to C to get to D. Honestly, just to go all the way over to Z. I don't know. Have I picked up anything that would reveal that to me? Something I haven't picked up. 1939 4 8 2. There was something else though. It was like 4 8 2 1. 4 8 2. Okay, so you had 4, you got 8, you lost 2. Oh, so it's 4, 8, if it's not 2, it's 6, so it's 4, 8, 6, 3. Puzzles! I'm honestly very amazed that I figured out how to use this combination lock first try, because I never figure out combination locks. I am so bad at combination locks. Now this is more like it.
Billy here.
Billy, I found an aerial cable car. We can get out of this place.
Go, wait there, I'm coming.
Roger, the sooner we get out of here, the better. Out.
Why do I feel like that's not going to work? Honestly, Billy, how are you going to get down there? You won't even jump. How are you going to get down there, Billy? Sure. Oh, that's how Billy gets down there. Output red coil. Wait, what's this one? Input red, output input. Wait, do I combine them? No. Doesn't seem to be getting any power. And that door's locked. So how do I unlock that door? It's locked, you can't open it. But how do I get inside? Because I feel like I have to get in there. Have I seen anything else to, like, put stuff into? Is it outside? Because it's not in the breeding room. not here. Doesn't turn around when you press the button. So the place doesn't have power. Which is strange, considering some lights are. Is it in the breeding room? Is it in here? Is it in here? Is one of these? No. Over here? Nope. Oh, hey, Billy.
Let's go.
Is it over here? Oh, there's a thing here. They missed this. Investigators report. Dr. Marcus, co-founder with President Spentoff of the Umbrella Corporation, disappeared 20 years ago. The results of his research have been kept under wraps the entire time. The research became clear here at the training facility run by Dr. Marcus. Well, not here exactly, but underground. When we ventured below, we understood. There we found the evidence of Dr. Marcus's research into the T-virus prototype called Progenitor. Evidence of years of hideous experimentation that used company employees as guinea pigs. We cannot know how many were forced to become subjects, but based on the evidence, no less than 20 individuals were involved. Some of them were taken deliberately to keep the corporation's secrets safe. Where the doctor is now, I don't know. But considering the recent rapid growth of Umbrella Corporation, I can't help but think that the research is continuing. Yes, his experiment lives and continues to grow in the dark. Those things, the fruit of his research, they fill this facility. This notebook page is missing. Oh no! How did I miss that? Oops. I got turned around. Okay. Okay, so I gotta go back to the cable car. I need to pick up the hook shot. Where's the hook shot? Where did I leave that at? I can look at the map and figure it out. It's there. It's apparently in front of me. I know it's in a save room. Oh, okay, so it's back at the thing, exactly where it needs to be. How do I get there? Okay, go through this door. There's like another door above me. So that one? Yes. So if he's gonna use the hook shot, he also needs these. There's northwest corner. So over there. Oh, maybe I use it on the cable car. Oops. So like up here. Over here. No. Oh, northeast. Maybe I just do it like right at the door. No. Oh, maybe. Found it. Just gonna go ahead and unlock that. No, unlocking it made me go through it. That's not what I wanted at all. Oh, goody. It says, switching robot's power input and output. You can use control to help while moving. Okay, good. Well, I'm in here. Did it. Good to see you, CB, and awesome. I hope you have a wonderful day so far. Hey, thanks. Thanks for dropping by. Yeah, I'm having a pretty good day. I'm here. I'm dragging some alcohol. Going pretty good so far. Thanks for dropping by. How's it going? Love dragging some alcohol. Me too, I love dragging some alcohol. And that's going to be it for this episode. I hope you all enjoyed. If you enjoyed the series, leave a comment, like the video, and I'll see you all in the next one.